Hey guys, so this week I brought a couple friends to help me out and teach the dances to you, okay? So you'll see some familiar faces as you go through the video, and I can't wait to see you guys at the end, okay? I hope you guys have fun. See you at the end.
That's my signal!
You'll see la nada.
Stretch out, get yourself ready.
I thought that I'd surprise my mother.
If you can thunder.
Start walking together, find a little beat. Down, good. Step, touch. Out, touch. Step, touch. Step, touch. Step, touch. Step, touch. Take one hand up, grab over by your ear, and just gently pull your head to the side to that shoulder. Breathe in. Out. Switch. Take your other hand. Gently pull your head to the other side. Breathe in. Out. Release that head up. Bring your arms up to a nice needle. Let's go to a half moon. Exhale.
Start running, run!
after our awesome aerobic warm-up, we now have a few basic musical theater dance steps that we have to make sure everyone at BARCLAY knows. Because whether you're in a Broadway dance class or a musical theater class or a show program, these are moves that you're going to be able to use in any kind of jazz class or Broadway dance class or routine, basically ever, okay? So a few basic staple steps. The very first one that we're going to work on, you might already know if you've done other musical theater stuff with us, is a four count grapevine, okay? So if you have your feet together to start, and we're going to step one foot out to the side. That's on count one. You're going to take the other foot that didn't just step, and you're going to cross it behind you. And there is going to be a little bit of a weight shift, so you're going to want to be careful, keep your weight nice and center. So we start as a pencil. The first two counts are count one is to the side, count two crosses behind you, count three picks up that front foot, puts it out to the side again, then you bring that other foot in, and you're on count four, okay? So we have, going this way, our other foot come out to the side, pick up our other leg, cross it behind us, pick up that front foot, cross it out to the side, and step it together. A little faster all together on a one, two, three, four. Ready? Here we go. One, two, cross behind, three opens up, four. One, open up to the side, two, cross behind, three, open up to the side, four. Again, one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Now let's see if you can add a clap onto the four of every sequence. Ready? Here we go. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Again, one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Now, if we all turn around, you stay facing the way you're facing, we all turn around and face the back wall. If we're gonna face the same direction as you, we're gonna do this. So for us, and we'll be starting, all of us together this time, we'll be on our left foot. Okay, so we're going to step out with our left foot so you can see it from a different angle. Here we go. One, two, three, clap, four. One, two, three, clap, four. Again, left, right, left, clap. Right, left, right, clap. Good job. We're going to turn back around. Now, here's what we're going to do. We're going to do that again, but this time we're going to count to eight. Usually in dances, not always, but a lot of times we count to eight. Counts of eight, phrases of eight. So we're going to do it both ways. Four and four would equal eight counts. So one whole phrase of eight. Here we go. Ready? Two, three. Here we go. With a one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Again. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And that is what we call our grapevine. If you guys can work on that this week, next class, we'll add on another four counts, make it a full eight count grapevine. So great job. We're going to move on to our next move of the day, which is another really important move, and it's called the pivot turn. Can we all say pivot turn?
Pivot turn.
Thanks so much, Mr. Ohm and Mr. Jason. Here we go. You're going to imagine that you're going to get your feet stuck in some really gooey, either slime or peanut butter, something where you can squish your feet around, but they can't actually get picked up, okay? So the first thing we're going to do, we're going to pick up our right, your left leg, our right leg. We're going to pick it up. We're going to put it down into that sticky peanut butter. Stick it in there. Now, squish around a little bit. See how you can move without picking up your feet? That's what you want to work with. That foot stuck down in there. And we're going to open up and turn to face the other direction without our feet actually moving, just sliding around. Then when we're facing the other wall, we're going to reach back, pick up that back leg, put it down in front of you, and now you're going to Complete your turn squishing around in that sticky peanut butter. Again, pick up that back leg. Hi-ya! Plop it down. Keep your feet right there. Turn, 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 turn to the back. Pick up that back foot, which is your right leg, and plop it down. Turn, 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 turn. Good job. Bring them back together. Shake it up. Shake it up. So, doing that again, okay, on the same leg you just did. We're going to pick it up on one. Pivot. Turn. Pick the back leg up again. Pivot. Now you're going to complete that turn. Now, what would happen? Let's see Mr. Ohm do this. Mr. Ohm, pick up that leg and stick it down in the peanut butter and spin around. Go ahead. Now, what would happen, Mr. Ohm? Now, pick up that back leg, put it in front again. What if you didn't go this way to complete your circle, but you tried to go back this way? What's going to happen? Look, oh, Mr. Ohm's going to fall down. Almost. See? So, because of that, it's okay. He's okay. You okay, Mr. Ohm? You good? Okay. So, you okay, Mr. Jason? Great. Okay. So, we're going to go ahead with our pivot turns, and we're going to really make sure that we unwind ourselves the right way so our legs don't get us all tangled up, okay? Think of making a whole spin. Here we go. Pick that leg, pick it up, plop it down. Ooh. Spin it around. Good. Pick that back leg up again, plop it down, and complete your turn. Good job. All together. Here we go. Pivot, turn, pivot, turn. Great job. Take those legs up. And let's try it on the other side. You ready, Mr. Jason?
I'm ready.
Let's do it. Pick up that other leg, the one you were not already using, and let's pick it up and plop it down in that sticky peanut butter. Now you should be turning to face the other way first. So the door you didn't normally see first, the window, whatever in your house that you didn't turn to the first time, you should be turning that way this time. Turn around. Pick up that back leg. Stick it in the sticky peanut butter. And complete your turn. Again, back leg front. Pivot. Turn. Good. Pick it up again. Pivot. And turn.
Miss Christine, I have a question. Are we always turning where our chest is facing?
Wherever. Wherever is going to open us, okay? Because your chest could still turn that way, but you could have your feet be all tightly wound. So whatever is going to help you open on a smooth turn. If you have to pick anything up or you get twisted, you're going the wrong way. This should be nice and smooth all the way around. Okay? So that was our second awesome move of the day. That was the pivot turn. Do any of you remember the name of the first move we did? The grapevine. Okay? So you have your pivot turn to work on and you have your grapevine. We also, just for review, did a couple cool moves in our aerobic warm-up, and that is the step touch and the double step touch. So just to review that right now, a step touch is when you take one foot, put it to the side, you take the other foot, and you just simply touch next to that foot. Then when that one is there, already lifted, already on a nice, what we call a bevel,
ooh,
you're gonna take that foot and step it out again, take that other foot in, and touch. Step. Touch, step, touch, arms come out, step, pencil for the touch, arms come out, step, and touch, again, step, touch. Now the double step touch, you go step together, and you're going to actually keep your weight going that way, so it's a double step, step, together. Now we go back, step, together, step together. So let's go ahead and do our double step. Here we go. Step together, other way. Step together, again. Step together, step together, step together. So now, if we're gonna put all those moves together, it's gonna look something like this. Grapevine first, here we go. One, two, three, four. six, seven. Again, here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Pivot, turn, step, turn, pivot, and turn. Again, step, turn, pivot, we turn, step, touch, step, touch, step, touch, step, touch, step. Now double step, step and touch, step and touch, step and touch, step and touch. Great job! So go get yourself a quick sip of water, and we're gonna put on some music, and we're gonna do that whole sequence all together to one of our favorite kids' dance show tunes. Ready? Okay, you have 2 minutes. We'll see you right back.
Who does she think she is? That girl has tangled with the wrong man. No one says no to Gaston.
Done right.
Dismissed, rejected, publicly humiliated. Why, it's more than I can bear.
More beer?
What for? Nothing helps. I'm disgraced.
Who, you? Never. Gaston, you've got to pull yourself together.
Gosh, it disturbs me to see you, Gaston. Looking so down in the dumps. Every guy here'd love to be you, Gaston, even when taking your lumps. There's no man in town as admired as you. You're everyone's favorite guy. Everyone's awed and inspired by you, and it's not very hard to see why. No one's slick as Gaston, no one's quick as Gaston, no one's next as incredibly thick as Gaston, for there's no man in town half as manly, perfect, a pure paragon. You can ask any Tom, Dick, or Stanley, and they'll tell you whose team they prefer to be on.
No one's been like Gaston, a kingpin like Gaston.
No one's got a swell cleft in his chin like Gaston.
As a specimen, yes, I'm intimidating.
My, what a guy that Gaston. If I'm a rush, if 12 hip hips.
Gaston is the best and the rest is all to rips.
No one fights like Gaston, does his life like Gaston.
In a wrestling match, nobody fights like Gaston.
For there's no one as burly and brawny.
All right, how many of you can recognize this song?
I was it is with deepest pride and greatest pride.
Beauty and the Beast, and it's called Be Our Guest. So let's follow along and get some of our moves to work.
The dining room proudly presents your dinner.
What's the first move?
Be our guest. Be our guest.
Slow.
Put our service to the test. Tie your napkin around your neck, sherry, and
out.
Provide those.
Again.
Soup du jour, hot or
two.
Why, we
three.
Only live to serve. Try the gray stuff, it's delicious. Don't believe
pick it up.
Ask the
go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Pivot, turn. Pivot, turn.
You take it.
Pivot, turn. Again. Pivot, turn. Pivot, turn. Step, touch. Step, touch. Step, touch. Step, touch.
Good.
Remember, you're a lion, so 1, 2, 3, four, five, six, seven, eight. By 7, 8, you should be up and ready to go into the next move, okay? The next move is 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 2, 2, 3, 4 is the first four, is only chest. Then 5 is right, 6 is left, 7, 8.
So guys, remember, when you get to the second count, after you get to 7, 8, you're on your feet kind of like a human animal, right? Then it's point, flex, point, flex. That's four counts of point flexing. 1, 2, 3, 4, or for counting in the sequence of 6 that we got, it's 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Beautiful. Now the next move is when you establish that you have arms now and you can move them. Okay, so Mr. Ohm is gonna do the movement and we'll break it down.
And we're on the three, right?
We are on the three.
Yeah.
This is our third count. Okay, ready?
Mm-hmm.
3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I hope you guys saw, when Mr. Ohm got to the 3, 2, 3, 4, 3, 4, 4 is when you let it out, your wave is completed. 5, 6, 7, 8.
So guys, this is a moment of discovery, like Mr. Jason said. Now remember, we went over the wave last week and you guys did amazing at it. Here's what it is in case you want a little refresher. It's out, out. Now it's wrist, elbow, shoulders, elbow, wrist, out. So once again, wrist, elbow, shoulders, elbow, wrist, out. And that's gonna happen on, is that the three?
That is the third set.
So it's gonna be 3, 2, 3, 4. So it's gonna be a little bit of a four count. So if I took away the three, it'd be like 1, 2, 3, 4. By the four, it should be done. Because the 5, 6 is our nice little clap. 5, 6, which help us remember that now we have legs. We're discovering arms and legs. So we slap our legs. 5, 6, and it's like our legs wanna respond. 7, 8. Yeah? Cool, let's do it all together with Mr. Jason counting from the three.
Ready?
Yep.
All right. 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Beautiful job. Now, you guys are gonna go into the up, downs. This is the step touches we went over, just a slight variation on it. Now you go to the back, okay?
It's a little bit like step touch meets grapevine in a way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, so.
And this is our
this
fourth?
Is our fourth sequence of eight, okay? Mr. Holm, you ready?
I'm ready.
Awesome. 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
And you guys should be professionals at this with how we did it last week, right? And like Mr. Jason said last week, in the music, you're gonna hear a whoosh. And that's how you know, hands up for that whoosh sound. Ready?
Let's go back to the same spot.
Let's do it again. And awesome. You know what's really cool about this? This is both the fourth and fifth sequence. You just do the same eight count back to back. Ready to count it, Mr. Jason?
Yes, I am.
Let's do it.
All right, ready? 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Again.
5, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Now.
Awesome job, guys.
Ooh.
Now we've reached the sixth count. This is the final one. So now you guys go into your step. You're gonna bring your arms up, make a muscle, really flex those arms, and then you're gonna come back down and you raise those arms high so everyone can see, okay? And then you bring them right down.
And your lion attack.
Now, awesome.
Going back to review the five. Would you count me off, Mr. Jason, from
yes,
the five?
5, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
So I'm already in a great position. So remember, when you start off, it's whoosh, and we always go to our right with the left foot, but we're going to the right. So if you want to think left foot, that probably is the best thing. The left grapevine touch, amazing hybrid. So it's, count me off from four. Let's do it again.
Awesome. 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Same thing.
5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Now I'm in the perfect position for the last part, Mr. Jason. You want to count me off slow so they can see this new move?
You got it. 6, 2, 3, 4.
So pay attention to that again. So on the 6 is the step, or the 1. 1, 2, 3, 4 is your flexing. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
So let's do that again.
Absolutely. Ready? I'm gonna go with 6 instead of 1, okay? 1. 6, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Nice, Mr.
So it's on the 8 that you do your line, right at the last count. Do it one more time.
Absolutely. Ready?
Yep.
6, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And make a nice face. Let them really see the fierceness in it, okay? Good. Good job.
All right, everyone, did you have fun learning that breakdown? Now we're gonna try to put it all together with the music. So I have not actually learned it from the breakdown. So I'm gonna be just like you, someone coming on in, trying to follow along. So I'm gonna have Mr. Ohm and Mr. Jason come up in front of me. We're gonna play the music from the beginning and we're gonna work through it together. All right, let's see how we put it all together with the music. Into the rest of the music. All right, let's do it.
Let's do it.
of beasts with quite so little hair.
I wanna be the main event, like no king was before. I'm brushing up on looking down, I'm working on my
roar. Thus far, a rather an inspiring thing.
Oh, I just can't wait to be king.
You've run a long way to go, young master, if you think.
No one's saying do this.
Now, when I said that,
no one's saying be there.
What, I mean, what?
No one's saying stop that.
What, you don't
no
realize.
One's saying see.
That's definitely out.
Free to do it all my way.
I think it's time that you and I arranged a heart to heart.
Kings don't need advice from little poor Phil's poor scars.
If this is where the monarchy is headed, count me out. Out of service, out of Africa, I wouldn't hang about. This child is getting wildly out.